Hello everybody, hope you're doing well. Today is the special day, September 23rd, 2017. I have noticed that there is many videos circulating right now on internet that suggest that today on September 23rd we will experience end of the world. This information is understood from Revelation chapter 12. Today I'm planning to decipher chapter 12 of Revelation using my unique ability of reading and interpreting Egyptian hieroglyphs. You will see that Egyptian hieroglyphs and Revelation actually related to one enormous project that was developed in our planet for humanity to learn a lesson. To introduce myself, first I like to show you several examples of work that I'm doing, mostly for my Russian audience, when I'm reading Egyptian hieroglyphs in Russian language. This is the language Egyptian hieroglyphs is meant to be read. So, as you can see, each of these Egyptian hieroglyphs is assigned with Russian letters, pair of Russian letters. So, they are comprised of a mind form that can be sensed and envisioned in a way that you can experience word and understand much deeper meaning that is embedded in it. So this is several more examples of how I'm working. As of right now, there is already several Russian people that learn from me how to work in the same way I do with Egyptian hieroglyphs. And more people becoming interested in this particular work and understand how important information that is in these texts. This is a few more examples. I didn't show you variety of things that I do. I pretty much saved my time and just pull images that was closer to me and saved some time. In reality, my website lightbeads.com have many examples of work like that. Perhaps I like to stop on one particular example just to show you how approximately you can hear ancient Egyptian / Russian text. And I will also translate for you one of these lines. This text is unique and it can be read from left to right, and it is very interesting text, and it can also be read from right to left, and it will be another very interesting text that relates to the first one. And actually, I know that Moses did wrote this particular line. Ади. Нельзя ж кого не поре, супа бущаная пай. Суроба це каниши не гоил ты. Ил по оди, спра ликоду по и. Ади, you know English word addition. That refers to add. Actually, материя, matter, forms from higher vibrational frequency of a consciousness, or another way to see it as a human soul. Adi is a name that is pretty much refers to this process. Нельзя ж кого не поре. You can translate it as you cannot just anyone. Супа бущаная пай. Feed with бущаный суп. Суп, that's just a soup that is food. But in another way, you can understand this phrase that adi, you cannot give information about bushane, which is burning bush, just to anyone. Nipore means the time didn't come. Surobe це каніше негоїл. From working too much, didn't have time to for your horses. But in reality, каніше, this is книжки, this is books, two particular books, Voynich manuscript and Codex Serafinianus is also related to this global enormous project that I was mentioning. And so this is about not having to have enough time to work on these books also, although there is already knowledge on how to read them. I have it. Ти іл по оді, спра лікоду по і. Do not rush, first of all, work on a hieroglyphs. Лікода, this is the Egyptian hieroglyphs and text. Partially it refers to milk, and we will be talking about it later if we will be doing more videos about it. Right now we're going too far from what we've been intending to work on today, and I will come back to our previous Egyptian text. So this is the phrase that I like to read and understand first. A great sign appeared in heaven. Everybody thinks that that relates to a eclipse that we experienced not long ago. A woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and a crown of 12 stars on her head. Well, yes, you can see that that is in the first layer appears to be connected to an eclipse. And yes, today is the day, September 23rd, I'm actually unraveling to you a next layer of knowledge that is embedded in this particular phrase, starting from, let's say, word appeared. This is the hieroglyphs that I would use to represent mind form up, which means up, like jump up or climb up in a ladder. Pia. In Russia, we call this bird petukh, rooster. Usually it goes up, and we know that there are some roosters that is presented on top of a ancient churches that refers to Petrus Romanus and a particular chicken that awoke him up from long dream when he forgot about real God. And I think you should understand what I'm referencing right now to. Anyway, the chicken is not necessarily waking up in the morning just as mine does every time the sun comes up, but also there is a rooster that is waking up entire humanity from the long dream when information about real meaning of our existence is forgotten. That is also mind form P. R is mind form that is relates to land. Whether or not it's land in your backyard or it's land that is covering up entire surface of the planet and is surface of the planet, or it's a small land, let's say for creatures that is minuscule comparison to a human being, all of that is R, even if it's a star, and that's still a surface in a land far, far away. Ye is a negative mind form. We will be talking about it in great detail later when we will be learning Egyptian hieroglyphs and how to understand them. As of right now, I just like to say that that refers to negative qualities of personality of each individual human, and collective human consciousness as well have negativity attached to it. And our collective consciousness is working towards getting rid of negative qualities so the world can be a better place, this one or the ones above. This is a triangle. We know that it's delta, and you can read it as D. In hieroglyphs, meaning of that is a trianon, not trianon in France, in Versailles, but trianon as a consciousness that is above our reality. And structure of that we will be discussing later on in the future videos. To explain this particular set of hieroglyphs that reads as word appeared, perhaps you can meditate looking in that word and you will understand how Egyptian hieroglyphs actually work. But I like to also introduce you to that chicken a little bit more. So as a hieroglyph it read P, unless he's screaming, in which case it will be read as Bud, which means waking up. This is the rooster, and if I write word rooster using Egyptian hieroglyphs, which is rune, this is the hieroglyph Ru. This is how rune is actually reads hieroglyph Ru. Рулон, скручивать, руны, русский, рубашка, рулон, рулетка. All these Russian words will have this particular mind form. And it refers to a hieroglyphs in a deeper meaning of it. This is the called svod in Russian language. You can see that as a part of a building structures, part of an arch, or a arch above our heads when you see at the stars. That called svod. Everything that is and under that is connected together under one umbrella kind of structure, and you read it S because it's SWOT. And this is our planet in ancient language, and still in French it refers as Terra. That's why you have word terrestrial and even eternity. And this is how you read rooster. So you have to see rune all together under one sword and planet Terra that is how you can understand this particular hieroglyph by writing it down, the whole word. And now we will continue moving forward. I will show you an example of how I understand, let's say, this particular mind form R. So I wrote several words that have combination of R, pair of sounds R. And like I said, it's a land, small or large or extra large, it's still land. That's why you have word far. See how it relates to land. Star also have land, far, far away, shining and different in temperature, but still are. Yard, your land, very small one. Bark, also land for somebody else, smaller creatures perhaps. Also, you can see this particular mind form in it. Arch, also land, also a surface that you can, let's say, inscribe Egyptian hieroglyphs or texts or paintings, still are. Abort, also sort of a territory or land inside of a ship or a plane. But you can see how it's are if you can move inside it or do something inside it or use it somehow. Accessories, access to an are, you can see it this way. Affairs is transformations of territory. You can probably understand what am I trying to accomplish and finish it just by yourself. We will not be taking our time on this particular action since we are working right now on understanding Book of Revelation. And then I right now wrote with Egyptian hieroglyphs a line, a woman clothed with the sun. Somebody think that this the sun is our star, or somebody think that this is Son of God. Either way, we will be writing that with Egyptian hieroglyphs, and I will be hoping that you will see what this line really means a little bit more. So W is sound that if stands alone in a separate mind form in English refers to a womb. All words one way or another would relate to this particular function, reproductive function, not necessarily a female reproductive function, but in a much broader context. O, separating one part from another one. This is knife. In Russia we have a word otrezat, this is why it's O. This is hieroglyph that reads ma. Think of mother, maternity. This is a big cell, life cell, that give birth to a small one, reproductive process. This is what this mind form represents. And inside of it is a matavila. The thread is twisted around it. This is a tool to collect yarn together. And that reads as N. In Russian language, we read C as K. So that refers to connection to something. Let's say this is the pile of snow that is connected to a wall it attached to. This is the mind form K. But in this case, same sound but written through C in the word closed. And my understanding that the best hieroglyph to use, although it's not Egyptian, made by me right now to explain you what it is eventually, is this way to show you, like in the word, let's say, Colorado, you will be writing it like that, and it's a symbol of Colorado. That means it's something inside. And C is actually a energy, same like in China, they say C, but we know it as Qi. Sine wave, like let's say energy, energy emission in the form of a sine wave. That's what you have to see this particular mind form with. Information is also sort of a sine wave when it comes from one mind to another mind. So law refers to a body, not necessarily a human body, but any kind of body in general. If you get as many words with combination of law, it will refer to some kind of body. There, you have to probably think of word theosophy that starts with there. That is actually refers to God. And we will be talking about it little bit later on. Again, D, we already familiar with delta. Sometimes there is I in it, which reads och, and together it's doch, which is daughter. This is the... So we looked at the word closed. And now if you meditate on that, you can see this word much, much better. You will see a God in it. And a Trianon, a consciousness that is above our collective consciousness. And you can see a sort of connection of a body. So, explaining with words a particular set of hieroglyphs is difficult. You have to start learning how to feel it. And as of right now, I'm just giving you an example. And once we will go a little bit forward, you will understand the phrase better, and you will also pretty much understand what I'm doing right now. Bear with me. This is a bottle of wine. This hieroglyph reads we, because we know. This almost like there, but it's only T and H. Z, like in word as or Asia. This actually refers to a human being, as. When you say in the English language, as she was about to give birth, as refers to a human consciousness. So, with, which means human consciousness that is currently experience a twist that known as wine. Remember how Jesus turned water into wine? That wasn't a water laterally and wine laterally. That was information that was complete knowledge, and a truth was transferred to be a information that was hard to grasp and twisted, so humanity will be tested. And this is what is a way to understand with. Once we will be going a little bit forward, you will see what exactly I'm talking about. As of right now, there is nobody that can explain real fast what I'm trying to convey, but eventually you will. We know refers to a teachings, many different teachings under one concept that is turning humanity towards a test and a separation of the ones that deserve existing in a better reality and the ones that have to be turned into matter. This is the truth that we will learn once we will decipher, let's say, this particular revelation book and the other ones as well. This we already look there, like in word theosophy. And this is the how you write word sun in Egyptian hieroglyph. This owl is the one that looking in opposite direction reads su, the word suprative, which means in English the opposite. So this particular one called sunduk, like this particular object, is actually sunduk. And it's the opposite from morduk, which is mind form that represent more. That's what we experience right now of our very unhappy reality. So sunduk is the one that connect, that is a collection of a knowledge that is left by God in our planet. So one day we will access that again and return to original condition of our knowledge and understanding of reality that we are in. And Sunduk, you can see that this is the tree of life that calls Dup. And I hope we will get to it again. I'm doing my explanation real fast because this is just basically introduction of what I'm doing, and you won't be able really fast to adapt to something that I'm trying to show you. It will take time. Right now I'm just trying to get a little bit closer to a woman that I'm trying to introduce you to. Everybody thinks that Statue of Liberty having a book in her hand, when in reality it's an arrow. You can see this corner here and this corner here. Now you can see this line here goes down, goes up here, goes down, and you can see this angle. So altogether, if you look closely, you will see an arrow. In that particular arrow, it says July 4th. Everybody thinks that this is Independence Day from Great Britain, which is probably true. But there is another truth to it. The word July, if you read it in Egyptian hieroglyphs, you will see this beetle that calls Zhuk in Russian language. And that represents, in Egyptian hieroglyphs, it represents actual God that left humanity as a continuation of his existence. This is a offspring of God, in a sense. Something that you have to think of a consciousness before you think of a body. But either way, this is the Zhuk in the word July. And as you know, chickens lay eggs. So Zhuk lay his eggs in this particular sphere. This hieroglyph is Ka, because this is refers to a catity and rotation. And you can see it as our planet as well, and humanity as offspring of this particular Zhuk, who is also a god. And we are here to develop ourselves in a way that we will be able to exist in another reality that is only taking people who deserve to be there. So, lay this particular photograph would be represented by a hieroglyph like that you can read as lay. That is what July is, the offspring of God that is placed in this reality in the form of a human beings. July 4th, we will be looking at that in several minutes. As of right now, I have to show you that word arrow. This particular object is written like that in Egyptian hieroglyphs, and it also would have a wound. This arrow shows the stomach of Lady Liberty, and it is written in Egyptian hieroglyphs, a little suggestion to look closely at this particular arrow. And then we can see that it suggests that Lady Liberty, in fact, is expecting a child. Then, it's not just arrow, it's the arrow. And I explained that the refers to a god. Like in the word theosophy, theo is God. Theosophy is a science about God. You can see it this way. In Russian language, we have T that called chai. Tio, tio used to be word for tea before, and it's a chai. Because of chai, there is China, there is Chechnya, there is Chechenitsa, and Czechoslovakia. All that is because of the, and also chai. And it's also shai for Arabs that say ashraba shai, you're gonna drink tea. And also for people that speak Hebrew, they will say shalom. That is same like shai, that is just sha, and so on. Then in English you can see that we have tan, that's why we celebrate Thanksgiving Day. That's why we say thank you. That is all the same. And we also use Tannenbaum in Germany. This word is same with this Christmas tree, but when we have a Christmas tree, that is still Tannenbaum, and Tann is the god in this particular case, is the same like this Zhuk, which is what you see here. So I hope I explained a little better. And the whole meaning of this reality that I already said is this ye have to turn into no ye. But that's in Russian language. But in English, no ye is can be seen as the. It used to be seen as Tihi. That is the ancient name of the Pacific Ocean. And it is still name for in the languages like Russian, tih и th in the beginning of the. That's how these words are connected. But again, I got a little bit carried away from my main conversation. So, if you look at this arrow in the Lady Liberty, we can see July 4th. 4th is a quatre. Qua is the sound that frog makes. Quatre is three frogs. About that will be important a little bit later on. So I wrote quatre using Egyptian hieroglyphs. And eventually, once you will understand all mind forms, you will understand better what it represents. This represents birth of a baby or a planet in our case. Planets are actually born, and we will understand it once we will start learning more about Egyptian hieroglyphs and what is written in them. But mostly I like to show you this particular coin to understand connection between Lavrentii Medici and Statue of Liberty. This is Quatros. Lavrentii Medici, you can see here Magnus, we will take part Mag from that. And from Medici we will take Med. Together will be Magomed. This is different from Muhammad. So this is the one that started Lajidaya family, if you research it a little more, and we will do it together. His Quatras in one language, and his Lagos in another language. And that is connected to a frog, because Lyagushka in many languages is the frog. So, qua, tre, quatre, quatras, Lagos, because quatre, that's Lagos. Just combination of different languages. And he is Lavrentii, that's why we have a lavr, the venok diadema that is on people's heads. And in Latin it's sinus, and that refers to sin, and also an original sin. And this is a page from Codex Serafinianus. This is a frog. So, I like to show you that this is also a Lady Liberty. I did write down what each of these figures in Codex Serafinianus represent. You see this hood. This is Hudson River, right? Hood. And river, you also can see that river, it's also, remember Paul Revere, let's say. Well, river, word reverse, you can see this particular part suggests that he have difficulties in moving forward. So Hudson River, river is not all word for river, but is also can be understand like that, like difficulty, like tension. Then you can see this pose and a costume of New Yorkers and the colors of even New York Yankees. So New York Stadium is there and Lady Liberty sort of facing it. This you can see in the huts and compare this part to Brooklyn Bridge, and these particular things you can see in the Brooklyn Bridge as well. And this part is not full in here, but it's 9 pieces like that. Each of them is a hieroglyph. Стой. This is what you use to stop animal, if you put this one on the neck. But it's stay 10 island, because it's gonna be 10th planet eventually formed. This is what is all this pregnancy is all about. And a transformation of consciousness of a collective human beings. This is Delfina, that's how the Verizanova, the guy, his name Verizana, was one of the first one to see Hudson River. And you can see that this is деталь, called дель, right? And then this is the fin. And this is hieroglyph ши, and this is пе. So this is дельфина, ship. And the colors is one of the old French flags. So this is Verizan, one brother, and this is another son. And she is represented as frog, with the frog is expecting a baby as well. And this is because this is quatras. And this is also a Lady Liberty. And in Russia we know about Princess Frog, of course. So let's go forward a little bit more. To understand a little bit more about Lady Liberty, first I like to introduce you. This is Catherine Medici. She is Maria Magdalena, if you will, because she is in the bloodline of Lorenzo de' Medici, who is Magomet. And she is Catherine Maria Romola de' Medici. So that's Catherine also the Great, in a sense. And if I suggest when you read Magdalena, you have to see that that refers to a nation. Na, that is mind form, na. Nation, I wrote. Internationally, international, nationality. All these words, you can see na refers to narod in Russian language, which means all human beings together, or one nation, or one group of people. Refers as на. That's why Екатерина, I wrote in Egyptian hieroglyphs her name. That's not one person. That's a name that also refers to humanity. And you can see that maybe you can see her consciousness as a queen is reflected on all humanity together. Then in her bloodline was another Maria de' Medici, also after Lorenzo the Magnificent. And then it was Marie Antoinette, another Marie. So there was three women called Marie. So when you look at Statue of Liberty and you sing O Mary Ka, you have to see this particular beetle that is cutted this particular ball. And you have to see O and then name Mary when you say America. So this is something to think about. And then let's look a little bit forward. So Marie Therese of France, I wrote this one with Egyptian hieroglyph. Again, Terra is our planet, and Sea is the hand that spreads seeds. You see, Dauphine is her name, and when I show you this Verizanova, Giovanni Verizana, that name of a boat was a name of Marie Antoinette. And this is when it becomes more important. This is what you can see in the Wikipedia page about Marie Antoinette. You will see this plate with this bug over the throat. I will explain details of this particular hieroglyphs here later on, but right now this is the bug above. Look at for example, as a bug on top of somebody's head that you cannot really recognize that person. Then there is Egyptian hieroglyphs that suggest that it is important to take this particular bug off. I will not be reading that in Russian, but I will read what it says, and it's much longer text. Brother. But in narrower, it was say brava brass, серость. Have to take it off. Look up for inheritance. Needle. That was the. This is the needle as well, in a sense, if you understand this word. Needle, and then once I've read that, I immediately understood that was the needle that I was looking at. And at that particular moment, I got the sense that it is suggesting that she is pregnant. And then I continued to read this text. You are welcome. Ready, grew up, reconna. Understand this word in English, same like Russians will understand. Press up, roya tables, calculatables, that refers to this particular book as well, the ones that is Codex Serafinianus. So that's reference to this book that I was having to read this text as well. Have to rip off Cromolo, this is the one. Grew up, Боже, kicking. Сужеял, which means prepared. Колян, sus. Колян, that refers to coal. We will explain this word later on. So I'm just reading it to you so you will understand that hieroglyphs is connected to this particular plate. And the one that is plate of Native Americans, Navajo people, actually, in particular, and I will be talking about it later on. And then underneath of that is a shell. And that is also important. Since this plate, this is the Navajo artwork, and actually the hieroglyphs that Navajo people are writing is quite Egyptian. And then This lowest plate you can see, this is same like in the Botticelli painting, which is the birth of Venus. And Lady Liberty is also a Venus. The way to look at it, Liberty is also Libra, which is a scale if you look at the zodiac. And it's also Весы in Russian, that's why there is Сын, which is Sun. So, and in the word Lady, you can see also Lay and Ad. That is important. And since it's a scale, you can see this word in a long description that is about Венера, Venus, which is Aphrodite. Хронос Севирт, Uranus Gentiles. You can also understand it sent to North solar system also have polarity like North and South. I will be talking about it later. For example, our planet would be referred, let's say, as Pluie, which is plume, which is for instance, a tern, that's the one that is in Jesus's head. This particular plant is tern, which is plume. So if we are on a Pluie, then south of Pluie will be actually other world, that is Elysium. So, Chronos Sivirt, Uranus Gentiles, that means descendants of Uran. And threw them behind him into the sea, the form, I wrote this word with Egyptian hieroglyphs, Am means consuming a vibrational frequency, feeding off them. So, in a sense, some of us that did not deserve to continue existence is in fact a food, our vibrations are. From his genitals give rise to Aphrodite, hence her name meaning form arising. Form is pena, again, here is rooster and here is, like I was explaining, народ, which is nations, humanity. So, emerge from drops of his blood, so emerge from his bloodline. He stood, states that Gentiles were carried over the sea a long time, and white form arose from the immortal flesh. With it, girl grew. The girl Aphrodite floated as. You see, people think this word ashore on a scallop shell, but you have to see us, and here word whore relates to word herd, which means people being together as a herd, and us is a human being. On a scallop shell, you know word scalp, something grows on top of the head. Scale and scallop have the same roots. And shell means empty, which means what was missing is understanding. We will go a little further. And here I was just trying to show you real fast that Venus, Libra, Lady Liberty, Libra, Venus, Venera, Divinus, all that is connected words, unraveling information, but it will take few videos to catch up. This is the words from the plate that we're looking in. At the first glance, this is a French revolutionary song, but it has a deeper meaning, and I will introduce you to it because it's very important, refers to all of that. Madame, we too, away from me. It translates in real English from real French, Madame Vitou have promised. De ferragocche to Paris, to cut everyone's throat in Paris. May soon quam anki, but she failed to do this. Grassana canoneers, thanks to our canoneers. Danzole carmagnole, let us dance the carmagnole. Viva le son, viva le son. Long live the sound, long live the sound. Danzona carmagnole, let us dance the carmagnole. Viva le son, di canu. Long live the sound of the cannons. So this is what people think it is. Now let's look at it a little bit deeper. Madame Vitou, I wrote word Madame, it is sort of Egyptian hieroglyphs. What word mad, you pretty much understand, means crazy, means angry, means have a lot of ye. Am is food, like vibrations that gets consumed by higher realm of existence, by angels. I will be talking about it later. Vitou, the tree of life, have, of course, a drei, that's what it calls, ветви. So this is the part of a tree of life. The ones that have a spiritual wisdom, which means мудрость. You have word капитолий or word тол, which means wisdom. Vitou is that part of tree of life, this part of humanity that can possibly absorb wisdom and get better and get out of this particular negative form of existence that we experiencing right now. So, this is what Madame Vitou means. Now we know word await, that's English word now. Not ave pro me, but await, like it's written in French, but can be read in English. Pro me, think of promise here. But Prometheus, that's what it actually meant to represent. Await for Prometheus. This is why Statue of Liberty having this particular tool in her hand with the fire that Prometheus can bring. Now, this is the that I was trying to show you. And this is U and S. Theos, but you can read it as Zeus. Pro me, promised Zeus. So that's the truthful meaning of this particular line. Deferagokshe tu pari. Defere, that means not fair. Ye, negative connotation. Negativity that have to be replaced. Gorger. We have word gorgeous in English, but we have word gordynia in, let's say, Russian language. Gordy, which means selfish. And word selfish, you have to see that you sell fish. That's a biblical story. People that bought fish, not all of them are that good nowadays, as far as their influence to this reality. Taught, that means teached, that means give information. The Ferragorger taught Paris. Word Paris, можно, you can understand as, for example, comparison, see part pari, disparity, pairing, preparing, pair, and all of it under SWOT, which means it's two type of people together that will be separated eventually. That's the whole meaning of it. It separates the ones that deserve existence from the ones that ruining existence from everybody else and for that didn't deserve it. My son Kuamanki. My son. You know Moses as Moisei. Mais son. That's also son. But that's Moisei, Moses. My son. This co-op. To understand it better, Koopa, think about it as getting in and out of water. Water is knowledge. Take knowledge off and people are acting based on their new belief system. And now you can see if they corrupt or not capable of being corrupt. That's the meaning of it. Monkey, mankind. Remember, quadras, qua. So this is similar to that, like in word quadras. Qui, mankind. Grassano canoneers. Look at G separately, then see race, rasa, humanity, all together. Anas. That means basic. That means like basic humanity. Каноеers. So, каноэ is a boat with the ones that have no е. And the ones that is riding this boat. Каноеers. The ones that is don't have negativity in them. Дансоля карманьоля. In here you have to see дан. Then you have to see sons. There is more than one son. Ля карма. Like human карма. Гнол. Гнол means band from Russian language. And е. That have to be banned to be noe. That's why there is Egypt. Ye being banned. That's why there is a hieroglyphs. Viva lesson, viva lesson. Lesson is actually lesson that humanity is learning. Vive, this is the vine that was given to people as a new knowledge so people can be tested. And this is the part of tree of life. Ветка, ветвь. And this is how word свет that is about to end means. Дансоля, карманьоля, вива лисон, ду канон. In this case, he is saying, yeah, you can shoot your cannon and be violent and become this particular arm. So your vibrations will be taken and you will be frozen to a level of matter. So this is what is the real meaning that we're starting to uncover. Well, have you noticed that this Lady Liberty have a chain? So, she is chained. And she is also stripped. This object that is under her feet, that is moon, which is Luna. To understand it better, remember, I show you this, July, that have Lu. So, Lu, that's lay, that's us. And Na means nation, means humanity. So, moon in Russian language is Luna. And Luna, if you turn it into Egyptian hieroglyphs, then you can understand that that is the word that describes all human beings together under one consciousness. And remember that consciousness had three frogs, quatros. That's because she's stripped. You can see consciousness as a star. This particular is Astra. It has 12 corners. That's why humanity that is walking on top of this Astra called pedestrians. So Astra is comprised of three pedals like that. Each pedal have 60 degree angles, four of them. And then if you duplicate it and turn 30 degrees, that will be a second pedal. And then you can do it again, and then it will be three pedals like that. And that's why it will be stripped. You have to think of a zodiac that have 12 zodiac symbols. We have 12 hours. We have 12 months. We have four seasons. So system of consciousness really reflects this particular system in it, but we will be talking about it a little bit later on. As of right now, I just wanted to show you what stripped, show you the star, and show you that you can see the star, although Statue of Liberty not standing just on the moon. It's quite different structure, but I can show you what it is. So the reason why we need word stripped to understand, strip it down to bone. The bone is actually bedro. Bedro is the bone. In Russian language it's bedro. I believe in English it refers to femme something. But we have a word bedrock because of bedro. Bedrock is actually that particular rock which is our planet. So she's chained and she's stripped. You have to see tree of life if you write this word with hieroglyphs. But you can see that this is not particularly stripped only. You can only see that it is a part of Astra. Two of them are here. And the third part is sort of missing. Well, that will be uncovered when we will continue reading Revelation. This is actually a clue to understand the book of Revelation, because you can see that would have been a perfect human consciousness in the form of zodiac. But it's only partially assembled, and we will be talking about it to understand more in a later videos. As of right now, I simply want to tell you her name. So chained and stripped to the rock, Andromeda is stripped and chained naked to a rock as a sacrifice to Seti the monster, but is saved from death by Perseus. Well, the word Perseus, you can understand Perse as persuasion. So Perseus is the ones that have to persuade humanity to change. Andromeda, as I explained, stripped and chained. Stripped, I show you the stripped star, Astra, which is a humanity consciousness, which is moon, she's standing on top of it. So if we read it closely, now we will understand that moon under her feet and crown of 12 stars on her head. Well, head, голова, means главное, means consciousness, not in head, but in her consciousness is a 12-star crown, which is Astra. That's why humans in reality all pedestrians. We are walking on it. And she represent humanity altogether. So that's why she is standing on top of Astra. And she is Andromeda. So naked, that thing that she is wearing called Nakitka. And humanity is naked because Nakidovit means thrown on top of a rock. Now, word sacrifice you have to see as sacrить face, sacri face. Remember, I show you this particular bug that is on her face. It makes it closed. So the face is becoming open once I tell you her name, Andromeda. So now that the sacred face to Seti the monster, so that means that she is Seti the monster, that have a face closed, sacra face. So, and Seti the monster I wrote with Egyptian hieroglyphs, sa, саженец, сажать. That's something that you put to grow a plant. This is represent matter, and this is negative mind form. I also wrote here word Andromeda using Egyptian hieroglyph. In here you can see an, like in the word angel, means base. Dragon, Andromeda, that's the dragon. This is familiar hieroglyph means cut, humanity from the rest of the existence. And this is met, bear, the ones that bear information from us to give us a test. And it also refers to Medici, since he is Medvedь and she is Medici. There is another way to write word Andromeda. Andrei is actually the first Andrei. If the parts of the tree is Drei, main part of it is And. And then Ro, space, everything moves and develops in a spiral. Mera, мерить, измерять. Measurements. Measurements is what this mind form is to measure human qualities. And da means developing upwards. So this is Andromeda. So Seti the monster. Let's work on it a little more. Seti means satisfaction. I wrote this word using Egyptian hieroglyphs, but the meaning of it is that everybody is trying to be satisfied. The difference is what is human being willing to sacrifice to get satisfaction. If human being is capable of losing good human qualities in order to be satisfied, then this particular human is not deserve to exist in the reality above, or in this one probably as well. So this what means Seti, the monster, which means that mon, stare, staring. So I will show you a little bit more to it. This is Mona Lisa. That's why it's monster. This painting have a biggest secret that known to man. Not that many men know this secret, but I do, and I will share it with you in the next few videos. So, Mona Lisa. Lisa, same like this is a fox. Lisa means Zora in Spanish, means zorky. If you see this triangle, this is a equilateral triangle with I in the middle, the symbol that you already know, but as I explained to you, the hieroglyph is D, the I is Och, that's Doch, so this is daughter. So Mona Lisa is monster because this eye is staring at the most important part of our planet in which information from God is stored for humanity to access and develop a way out of our current problem that we experience with our existence. So this is what we can learn by understanding a little bit of who this woman in Revelation is. And a little bit later we will continue our research in this subject. As of this particular moment, this was first video I ever did in English language. Thank you for your attention. I will be better on later on, as I will be learning how to present myself better. Thank you very much for your attention. Please subscribe to my channel. Give me your suggestion how to present information better. As of right now, have a good time. Thank you. Goodbye.